This topic configures your Rotary engraver for output via Engrave menu, Output. Launching your engraving product prompts for plate size. Set origin for on-screen object coordinates. Set dimensions of the loaded material. Specify the material. Choose Engrave menu, Engraving defaults. Verify the driver and the loaded tool. When cutting multiple passes to progressive depths, choose multiple pass or router per the machine. When there are two or more tools that must be manually swapped out, set Engrave by color to on and swap tools when prompted. It is expected that object colors are organized according to the required tool. Click Page to cut with respect to the machine origin. Click Sign Plate to cut shapes with respect to their positions within the sign plate. By default, the Output Toolpaths checkbox is typically enabled. If so, then clear the checkbox. At this point, objects are cut per the tool options, feeds, and speeds. Otherwise, click Output Toolpaths again and enable this option to process tool paths. Clear this option, otherwise object contours are output in addition to any tool paths assigned to those objects. Click OK, then click Apply. Click Tool Options for feeds and speeds per the material. Click Setup to configure the machine. Set tooling start and end positions. Confirm that the machine limits are correct. Dimensions of the loaded material cannot be larger than these limits, otherwise tiling will occur. Click Notes for additional machine info. Ports are discussed in a separate topic. These are advanced options for special adjustments. With setup complete, apply toolpaths and output a test job to confirm settings. Choose Engrave menu, Output. Confirm the tool, device, machine limits, and material. Note the material dimensions in relation to the machine limits. If there are unexpected tiling lines, then review your machine limits and plate size. At the far right of the Cut toolbox, click to send output.